Okay, so it's almost 1:05, and I hope the screen is visible. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so just within 2 minutes, I will solve the query of Amit Singh. Then I will go back to the AC power. Okay, so Amit, look, if your lagging leading concept is clear, then there are two kinds of circuit. I hope you know, series RLC circuit and another one is parallel RLC circuit, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
This is one series RLC circuit, one AC source is applied. I am not drawing that. Okay. Now, another one is RLC parallel circuit. Okay. Here it is. RLC parallel circuit. Okay. So now here, look, this is your R, this is your XL, this is your XC. Okay. If L and C values are given, then no problem. And what is your reference here? Current. Because in case of series RLC circuit, in case of series RLC circuit, the I is your reference, okay? And since I is here, your reference, then I will be drawn along the x-axis, okay? And here, when current is across the R, VR will be developed. Here VL will be developed, here VC will be developed, okay? So I and VR always will be in phase, okay? And in case of inductor, which one is leading, voltage or current? Which one is voltage? Okay.
Voltage.
So at that time, the voltage will be in leading condition. Then, this will be your VL. Okay? And in case of capacitor, voltage will be in lagging condition. So, this is your VC. Okay? So, this resultant y-axis is nothing but VL minus VC. Okay, so whatever triangle you are getting, okay, now this is wrong actually. You have to draw the resultant vector, resultant voltage, okay, resultant voltage phasor. So this is your resultant voltage vector. It is nothing but your source voltage, Vs. So this triangle. Okay, this triangle, suppose I am naming this as A, okay, this is as O, this is as B. So this AOB, this triangle is called the voltage triangle, okay. Triangle AOB is called the voltage triangle, and whatever angle is developed here, suppose theta, so you can say that I is basically lagging. Right? This is, I can say that I is lagging by theta angle. Okay, that I can say. So this triangle is called the voltage triangle. Right? This is called voltage triangle. Now, similar case, okay, someone, just a minute. Okay. So, next we are going to draw the current triangle here. Now, in case of parallel circuit, which one is your reference? Quickly tell me.
Voltage.
Voltage is your reference. Good. So, I can say that this is your source current IS. Okay, and now it has three parts to get divided, right? So this one is your IR, this current is your IL, and this current is your IC. Okay, so now if V is reference, so here in case of IR, where it will be? It will be in phase, that is along the x-axis, isn't it? Because in case of resistor, voltage and current, they must be in phase. Concept clear?
Yes, sir.
Here I am drawing IR. Okay. Now, if voltage is here, so where will be the IL? In case of inductor, current is always lagging, isn't it? Here is your IL. Is this concept clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, and then in case of capacitor, because in case of capacitor, current will always be leading position. So, this is your IC. Suppose IL is greater than IC. Okay. I am assuming that. You may assume that IL is less than IC. Then the triangle will be on first quadrant. And since I am considering IL is greater than IC, so your resultant Y magnitude is here in fourth quadrant. Your triangle will be in quadrant. IL minus IC. So what is your source current? The resultant of this current. So this is your source current, I is the resultant current. So this triangle, suppose I am naming it as X,
so
Y. Yes?
So someone is waiting outside.
Okay, just a minute. Actually, it is problematic here. Okay. They are waiting. Okay, fine. Just a minute. Yes, sir, bolo. Kona chhe, sir? Ami class ni chhe, sir, basically. Photo ana chhe, ana chhe, sir. Yes, sir. Haan, sir, ekdam. Thik hai, sir. Okay, sir. Okay, now, here look. This XY triangle is this triangle X, O, Y. This is called the current triangle. Okay? This is called the current triangle. Now, if this angle is your theta 1, okay? So, what you can say that current IS, current is leading, or you can say the voltage is lagging. Okay, you can say current is leading by theta 1 angle. Okay, clear? So is the concept of current triangle, voltage triangle for these two cases clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So I am moving to the power section. So now we will discuss the power in AC circuit. Yesterday I already told that how many types of power are there. Tell me. Yes?
Two types. Active and reactive.
Exactly. Reactive.
Two types of power. Active power. Okay. Active power. And this active power value you will get from the I square R value. That means the power loss across the resistor. That is basically the active power. Okay. And another one is the reactive power. Okay. Now two types of reactive power are there. One is inductive. Okay. One is inductive. Another one is capacitive. Okay. Another one is your capacitive, right? And what is this total power called? Total power is called the apparent power. Okay? It is called the apparent power. It is denoted by the letter S. Okay? Active power is called basically P. And reactive power is called Q. I told you not to write R, capital R, because you will get confused if one resistor of value capital R is present in the system. Okay? So it's better to write this reactive power as by using this letter Q. Okay? Now, inductive power, capacitive power, it will be denoted by QL and it is by QC. Okay? Now, how can we calculate this power? So power is basically calculated as apparent power is basically calculated. I am giving it a one vector sign because it is the combination of active power and reactive power. That means you can say it is one type of complex power. Okay. Because active power you can measure. You have the meter at home where you are observing the unit's consumption. Okay. So whatever power you are observing that we can measure, it is basically active power. Okay. Whatever power loss you are observing, you observed in a lab experiment, that was in watt meter. So that was the active power. Okay. Reactive power you cannot measure, but reactive power is very important to maintain the voltage level, to maintain the power level, the stability of the system. Okay. So it is basically the complex power. Okay. And this formula is V into I star. Okay. This V means it is the RMS value of the voltage. I is the RMS value of the current. Okay. This formula you have to remember. This one is very important formula. Okay. Now, suppose I have this kind of system. Okay. This is your current. Okay. This is your, suppose this is your voltage. Suppose take this is as your voltage. Okay. And this one as your current. Okay, this is your V and this one is your I. In between them, angle is theta. Okay, so can I write this voltage vector V equals to V angle 0 degree and I as I angle theta. Can I write it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So
yes,
what kind of circuit is this? Give me one idea. Whether it is inductive or capacitive?
Inductive.
Inductive circuit. Because see, the current, why you are saying it is inductive? Because current is leading in nature, na? With respect to voltage. In case of inductive, voltage will be in leading condition, not current, isn't it?
Yes.
So this circuit is basically one capacitive circuit. Okay. This is called one type of capacitive circuit, right? Because see, the current is basically leading here, not voltage. Voltage is in the reference. Current is leading. Okay, someone, just a minute. Okay, so now I can write this as here. Okay, this V is basically the VRMS value. Okay, this is your VRMS. This is your IRMS. Okay, So this V vector, that means your V RMS vector, I am not writing here. Let's write here. Okay. How much time it will take? This is V RMS. This is your I RMS. This is your I RMS vector. Okay. So now I am writing here. This S equals to what I can write in place of V RMS, because these are all vectors. Is it? Now, in place of V RMS, I am writing V RMS angle 0 degree into, in place of I RMS, I am writing I RMS angle minus theta, because this star means the conjugate of the complex number. Okay, so angle becomes negative. So now I can write V RMS into I RMS angle minus theta. Okay, now I am converting this one into the coordinate system. How? Into Cartesian coordinate. V RMS into I RMS into cos theta, okay, minus J into V RMS into I RMS into sine theta. Up to this, is it clear to you? Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, what is this S is called? It is nothing but the complex power. Okay. So, this S I can write as P plus JQ. Okay. I can write it. So, now equate this one. So, from here you will get P equals to, if you equate these two, okay, if you equate these two, then you will get these values. P equals to V RMS I RMS cos theta, okay, and this Q value is minus of V RMS I RMS sin theta. Okay. Now, what is the type of the circuit here? It is one type of capacitive circuit. Okay. So I can write in place of Q as QC, right? So I am again writing here QC. So now you are observing that this QC value is basically negative. Okay. If this circuit is inductive type, okay, if this circuit is one inductive in nature, suppose I am drawing another current, okay, suppose it is another circuit where the value is I RMS, okay, angle is theta 1. Okay, this is suppose I dash RMS and this angle is theta 1. So this is inductive circuit. Okay, step by step try to understand. If you have any kind of confusion, tell me. Okay, this is inductive circuit, right? So in that case, what I can say, in this case I can write as P equals to V RMS I dash RMS into cos theta, okay, then Q L equals to V RMS into I RMS dash into sine theta. So that's how you are going to calculate the active power and reactive power for different circuits. Okay, in case of inductive circuit, the Q QL, the reactive power value will be always positive. And in case of capacitive circuit, the QC value will always be negative. So till now, if you have any kind of query, speak. Okay, do you have any other query regarding that means up to this that I discussed, or shall I proceed? Is it okay to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Is power section? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, suppose one you take one simple circuit. Okay. Suppose you take one simple circuit. This is your L value. Okay. This is your R value. Okay, one voltage is here. This value is suppose 100, or suppose take it as 10, not take 100, 10 angle 0 degree. Okay, this is your voltage. Okay, this is suppose your VRMS voltage. Okay. This L value, suppose 1 ohm. R value is 1 ohm. Okay. So how we are going to calculate the active power and the reactive power? How will we calculate P value and QL value? So first, what we need to do, we need to find out the current value, the I value, then only you can calculate, right? Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so tell me, what is the Z value? What is the total impedance in this circuit?
R square plus
1 plus 1. Actually, this one is imaginary. This is inductor. Okay. Because this is your R. Here is your XL. Okay. This R value is 1 ohm. This XL value is 1 ohm. So your Z. This is your Z. Okay, so Z is nothing but, if you write the Z equals to R plus J into XL, isn't it? So this is your impedance of this circuit. Now, I need to find out the current value. Okay, and I told you that if you have multiplication or division in calculation, better to do that in polar form, because it will help you. It will help you to save your time. Okay, so 1 plus J, can I write this? Check everyone. Can I write this?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
now
sir.
Calculate the value of RMS current, because voltage is also given in RMS. If not given in RMS, then you have to convert that. Okay, here I am giving the RMS value. So you have to consider the RMS current here. So RMS current is VRMS divided by the Z value, that is root 2 angle 45 degree. Okay, so this value is nothing but 5 root 2. Okay, if at any point, if you think there is one mistake in calculation, tell me. Okay, Now this is your minus 45 degree. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So now V RMS value, I RMS value you have in hand. So now calculate the power. So calculate the complex power directly, that is V RMS. Okay. I am again writing the formula V RMS vector into, okay, this is your dot product and this is your I RMS vector. Okay, in place of VRMS, what I can write? 10 angle 0. Okay. In place of IRMS, I am writing pi. Okay, this is your IRMS star, isn't it? I again did one mistake, but you didn't tell me. This is VRMS into IRMS star. That means the conjugate value. So 5. Okay, this is your root 2. Okay. Angle 45 degree. Okay. So from here, I can say this value is 50 root 2. Okay. Angle what? 45 degree. Right? Up to this, is it okay?
Sir?
Yes?
In IRMS, the angle is in minus sign.
Minus 45 degrees. So
yes. Minus
45 degrees.
Yes?
And you put there in the value of S, positive 45 degrees.
Yes, here yes, conjugate is there now.
Look yes, at sir, that is why
minus minus plus, sir. Yeah, get it.
Yes, because conjugate value, what is the meaning of conjugate? A plus IB, the sign will get changed to A minus IB.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and in case of this polar system, if your value is R angle theta, then its conjugate will be R angle minus theta. Okay, so here minus angle is given, so it will be positive after conjugate.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So the conjugation process is also applied on the angle. That's what.
Yes, obviously, conjugate process is applied on angle only.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Wait, wait a minute. Who is present here? Okay. The conjugate system is applied only for angle because magnitude will be same here. Look, this case magnitude is what? Root under of a square plus b square. So whatever do the conjugate or not, the magnitude will remain always same. Only what will be the angle, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, so S value is 50 root 2, 45. What is the unit? The unit is called the VA. VA. Okay. The S unit, the unit of S is called basically in mega volt ampere, that is called MVA. The unit of power, that is you already know, that is watt. Okay. In mega sense, it will be called megawatt. And the reactive power is called MVAR, or you can say VAR. Okay, here you can say watt if you don't use the mega sense. Mega means 10 to the power 6. Okay, or you can say here VA. So here unit is VA. The unit of S is VA, right? So now we are converting this S in P plus JQ form. Okay, that means in complex power. So I can write 50 root 2 into cos 45, okay, plus j into 50 root 2 into sine 45. Till now, if you have any query, you can speak. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay to all, na?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, what is the value of cos 45? That is 1 by root 2. Correct? So,
yes, sir.
Will be cancelled. Root 2 will be cancelled. Plus, this value will be 50J. So, what is your active power? So, your active power is 50. Active power is 50 watt. And the reactive power is also 50. That unit is called VAR. VAR. Okay, so that's how you have to solve the problem. Okay, if you can remember the formula, okay, this is the total arithmetic process. Okay, now if you can remember the formula, that will help you. How? Because what is the power value? What is the active power formula? That is VRMS, IRMS, cos theta. Is it? VRMS, IRMS into cos theta. What is the theta means? Theta means the angle between V and I. Okay? And so from here you can write also VRMS 10, IRMS value is 5 root 2. And what is the cos theta value? That is cos 45. Okay, so if you multiply, you will get the same value, that is 50 watt. Okay, now next one is your XL. Here inductor is present, right? So the inductor, this reactive power will always be positive in case of inductor. So I will directly write, if you remember the formula, VRMS, IRMS, sine theta. Okay, so the value is also 50. Sorry, this is not, this is only VAR. So either you can solve using this formula, okay, or you can follow this process. Okay, both processes are same and they will give you the exact same value. Okay, so ultimately what we learned that S value equals to VRMS into IRMS conjugate, okay. Now, next formula is P equals to VRMS IRMS into cos theta. Okay, next, if inductor is present, the reactive power will always be in positive. Okay, VRMS, IRMS, sorry, this value will be sine theta. And if capacitance is there, then it will be minus VRMS, IRMS, sine theta. Okay? And from this complex power, you can generate S equals to P plus minus JQ. Why I am writing plus minus? Because the element with resistor, it may be the inductor or maybe the capacitor. So as per our calculation, this sign will change. So these are the formulas that you have to remember for power calculation. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, yes, sir. Here, what is the power factor? Power factor value. Do you remember what is the power factor value? That is the cost of
theta.
Theta, exactly. Cos of theta. Okay. Now, what is the range of this theta? Theta range means
80 to
180, isn't it? Okay. But the cos theta value, whether this theta is negative or positive, but cosine of the angle will always be positive. Right? So, this value can be from lowest 0 to highest 1. Okay, this value will be lowest 0 to 1. And what is our motive, our objective for home? Our factor will be higher. Okay, because look, from the value of P, what is P is VRMS into IRMS cos theta, right? So, equals to, I can say VRMS, RMS into the power factor value. So, if power factor value is more, power will be more. Okay, you will get more active power for you. So that is basically the question. Okay, if you have any query, you ask, you can ask. And I just stop the screen sharing and I will go to the theoretical part. Okay, just a minute. Okay. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the reactive power that I already discussed. This is, see, the capacitive power that is always negative. Okay? Whatever I discussed there, the hands-on calculation, they are already same, already written with graph. Okay, now, this apparent power already I discussed. Okay, see here, this apparent power S, here it is P square plus Q square, S square equal to P square plus Q square. This is called the power triangle. Okay, it is called the power triangle. Right, see here, the real power is denoted by what? The reactive power is denoted by VAR, that is volt ampere reactive, and apparent power is denoted by this unit, that is VA. Okay. Now, here, look, real power equals to apparent power into power factor. Okay. What is the power factor? The power factor is the angle between voltage and current. Okay. Also, you can say, if, see, this is your P, okay? This is, suppose, your Q, okay? And this is your, suppose, S, okay? So, this angle is your theta, okay? So, now, what is the value of power factor? That is the cos theta, okay? So, cos value, you can say it is P by S from this figure. Okay. What is tan theta? tan theta is nothing but the Q by P. Okay, because this vertical line is nothing but your this reactive power. Okay, and in positive y-axis, whatever reactive power is there, it is always inductive, and the capacitive power will always be in negative y-axis. Okay, now this one is one short numerical. Okay, so just try to solve it very quickly. I will help you here. Okay, now look, a series resonant circuit consisting of the resistor 30 ohm, capacitor 2 microfarad, and inductor value of 20 millihenry is present. See here, 30 ohm, 20 millihenry, and 2 microfarad. Okay, and sinusoidal voltage is applied here, 9 volt. Now look here, is this the RMS voltage? No. If nothing is said, you must consider that this is not your RMS voltage. You have to convert it. Okay, you have to convert it. Now, look, you have to calculate the resonant frequency first. So what is the formula for resonant frequency? FR equals to 1 by 2 pi root LC. I hope you can remember. Okay, from here you are getting this value. Okay, put the value of L and C, then you can get this total value, 796 hertz. Okay, then the circuit current in resonance, and I hope you remember that during resonance the circuit will act as one resistive circuit, so only R is present, right? This portion will act as one short circuit. Okay, I hope you remember that. Now, what is the maximum current? That is V by R, so 0.3 ampere. It is easy. Okay, next one is the voltage across the inductor. So how will you calculate the voltage across inductor? That is nothing but the I into XL, correct? So how will you get the value of I? I value is already known, correct? What is the value of XL? It is told that at resonance. So this will be 2 pi FR into L. So whatever value you get, that is the voltage across the inductor. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, yes, sir. This here, VL and VC value, you are getting as same, right? And what is the quality factor? The quality factor represents the nature of the circuit, whether the circuit is very good or not. Okay? Here, look, the quality factor is 3. How you are getting? It is nothing but the ratio of XL by R. Okay, so that is the Q factor, that is 3.3. Okay, so that's very easy to calculate. Okay, now this is the next numerical. Okay, one parallel circuit. Also here, the resonant frequency FR, that is same, just like the series circuit. Okay, so here the frequency is 32.5. Put the value of L, put the value of C, you will get the value. Okay, look again, here VS is given as 100 volt. That is the peak voltage. Remember this, it is the peak voltage. So when you are going to calculate the power, you have to convert. Okay, I am writing here for...
Sir, Sohail is writing. Sohail is writing outside.
It's 150. Why you are telling me?
You're messaging me in WhatsApp.
Okay, So I cannot allow him actually. It is 150. I am already closing this. I am concluding today's class after this numerical. Okay. So for calculation, this peak must be converted into some RMS value. Okay, that you have to remember every time for AC circuit. Okay. Now here look, the inductive reactance value at resonance you can calculate. The quality factor for resonance circuit is just the opposite of the series circuit. Okay. In case of resonance circuit, the quality factor is just the opposite formula of the series circuit, that is R by XL. So this one is new to you. Okay. This one you have to remember. Right. What is the current at resonance? Again, the circuit will act as one resistive circuit. So only voltage you need, that you have already 100, and R value you already have, that is 1.67 ampere. Okay. So that's for today. I have one meeting to attend. Okay. So all of you give your attendance in the chat box. And if you have any kind of problem in understanding regarding the topic I discussed, you can ask. And this study material I will upload today. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Amit, is your query clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay,
thank you
fine.
For that, sir.
Thank you. Okay, those who have given their attendances, they may leave the meeting. Your class is officially over.